Can anyone find the lighter? There goes Zuki. Where's he going? Too close to the fire. Oh, wow, wow, wow. I have so much control with this laser pointer. All right, Zuki. Well, I'm sorry. I feel like I just upset him for a long. Here, go out of frame. And there he goes. Guys, welcome. What's up? And welcome to Wednesday night. We're in December and I have the Christmas vibes going. Very excited. As you can see behind us, we've decorated. We're ready. We were playing Christmas music well before Thanksgiving. So, yeah. Oh, here's Thea. Can we get Thea to come? Hey, Thea, what do you think of this? Oh. Actually, I've never done this with two of them. Oh, my. Oh, wow. So much power. I gotta stop. I'm getting
drunk with power.
Well, today is gonna be a fun day, and we're gonna be in our third week of sharing our faith. So high schoolers, you guys are gonna go in a little deep today. Middle schoolers, we're gonna have some good times. But before we do anything, I have to introduce a new segment we're doing. You guys know Nate Yoder. You've probably never seen his face, but he's the one that's been editing the videos. I used to edit the videos. That was in my past. I used to edit videos. Now Nate Yoder is editing videos. So we have a new section for Nate. I just handed him some footage. Jill, it was your birthday back 2 weeks ago. I'm sorry, but we're gonna see some amazing things happen. So without further ado, it's a new segment. Let's hit it.
Nathan Yoder's gonna edit. He's gonna do his thing. He's gonna edit it all around. Nathan Yoder's gonna edit.
Oh my God. Oh, was that an elephant?
Wow.
Okay, guys, you know that Nate Yoder has been editing our videos, but I want to give him a challenge. I'm just going to walk through the halls. I'm going to take a picture of someone, and then I'm just going to give him the picture and see what he does with it. Let's see what happens. Okay, we're going to take a picture of Jill jumping. It's her birthday tomorrow. Happy birthday.
Thank you.
Okay. Okay, give it a jump. 3, 2, 1, jump.
When I think about sin, whatever, whoever you are,
man, Nate, good stuff. I haven't actually seen it, but I'm sure whatever was just on the screen was incredible. Wonderful, guys. Hey, we're going to jump into some announcements for the night, things that are going on that you guys need to know of. Number one, December 11th, we are going to do the Christmas Penfield Blast. That is coming up. It's going to be Saturday, 11 to 2 at Penfield. So a lot of you guys go to Penfield High School. It's going to be just up the hill from your school, over the track in there. And there's going to be the U of R Yellow Jackets. They're the a cappella group. They're going to be there. It's going to be awesome. There's horse-drawn carriage rides. Fantastic. I'm pretty sure there's a snowman building contest, free hot cocoa. There's like a lot of good stuff going on. It's a great time to just invite a friend. Hey, we're gonna swing by. Do you want to come with us to this Christmas Penfield Blast? It's a very easy invite and we want to see you guys there. It'll be really great. I mean, they're gonna have fun. So if you're looking to hang out with a friend, text them about that and you can go to that. I have graphics on our Instagram that you can grab and share as well. So do that. December 15th, we are coming back on Wednesday night for a night called, let me remember it. Oh yes, Not So Silent Night. We are having a Not So Silent Night here at Youth Group from 6:30 to 8:30. Guys, this is gonna be a time where there's trivia, there's cookies, there's ornament making, there's card making, there's photo booths, there's dodgeball, there's all types of stuff. We're gonna be blasting Christmas music. Wear your ugly sweater. Wear your ugly sweater to that as well, because that is gonna be a fun time. Easy invite for friends. I mean, you can invite a friend who you just wanna have a good Christmas time with. You get to mingle, you get to go all around the church and do those activities. So December 15th, don't miss that. That's gonna be our last youth group before Christmas. So that's awesome. Two last things. Flower City Work Camp is coming up. Flower City Work Camp. is coming up. So you guys got to sign up for that by January 16th. So don't miss that. And Snow Camp. Snow Camp is going to be really fun. Some of you just missed the early bird special, so you have to pay 30 bucks more. But signups are still going on for a while. That's going to be in February. There's a ton of fun things. It's a retreat, guys. It's a retreat, but this one's kind of bolstered with a lot of fun activities. And Thea's back here just meowing away. We are going to transition into a time of silence and reflection. This is what I need you to do. Leaders, you guys have scribe pads. I want you to go ahead and get the scribe pads and hand them out. Everyone needs to have their scribe pad. If any of you are new, welcome. You get your own journal called the scribe pad, and you get to use that tonight, which I'm super excited about. That will be great. And so go ahead and pass those out right now. And with a pen or pencil as well. And this is, I always like to say this, if the overhead lights are on right now, the like big bright ones, go ahead and turn those off. It's always nice to just have the LEDs at this time. As long as you can see your journal, your scribe pad, then we're good. So go ahead, pass those out. We're gonna take just a couple more seconds to do that right now. Get your pens and pencils. I hope you leaders, if you saw the new bins, that's very nice. Also, while you're doing that, habit journals. Guys, I've been using my habit journal a lot more lately, and it's been really great. So I encourage you, when you guys get home tomorrow, if you haven't been reading your Bible, go for it. Go ahead and read that. Maybe start in Luke 1, read about the birth of Jesus as we enter the Christmas season. Use your habit journals because it's been so nice for me. And I always want to see you guys in service on Sunday, taking notes in those habit journals. So, all right, all of you guys should have your scribe pads at this moment. And this is what I need you to do. I need you to sit down, make sure you're sitting. And we're just going to do a quick little breathing exercise because we're going to really just relax here. And it's going to be really nice. So have your scribe pads ready, and then I just want you guys to close your eyes with me and go ahead and we'll do some breathing. So breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out, and then do very relaxed on this one. Breathe in, breathe out. Wonderful. Well, guys, tonight we're talking a lot about hope and how about Jesus brings us hope, and where there isn't hope, we should bring hope to others. So this is what I need you guys to do in your scribe pads. We're going to be doing a little exercise on hope. And what is hope? Hope often is understanding and knowing that things are going to get better. That things are going to remain good, or they're going to get better. There's light at the end of the tunnel. I'm going through something hard right now, but I know that things can get better, and I feel it. I feel that things can get better. We know that happens through a relationship with God, but this is what I want you guys to do today, and I want you to be honest with it. I want you to write down the first one. I want you to write down school. Go ahead, take your pencil, write down the word school, okay? And now I want you to think, on a scale of 1 to 10, how much hope do you have for school? How much hope do you have that school's going to get better? How much are you loving school and it's great and you feel very hopeful? This new year's coming and you're excited to get back into it? Or are you on the other side of the scale where you're like, you know what? I wish I wasn't in school. School's really tough. I don't think it's ever going to get better. That would be a 1. Where are you? Scale of 1 to 10, how much hope do you have for school? Go ahead and write that down and be honest. 1 through 10. Okay. Wonderful. Now I need you to write this down. Go ahead and write down friends. Write down in your scribe pad right beneath school, write down friends. And I want you to think, on a scale of 1 to 10, how much hope do you have for friendships? Are you someone who you know, you have a really good friend group and it's awesome and it's getting bigger and you went and played laser tag or you had a painting party or something and you're like, wow, I love my friend group, 10 out of 10. I can see it getting better and it's already great. Or are you someone who, you know, you've been struggling to find friends. You went through a year of not seeing anyone during COVID and now it's just kind of hard to interact with people and you actually don't see it getting any better. Is that you? Are you low on hope today in friends? So scale of 1 to 10, how hopeful are you for friends? Put it down. Wonderful. Next, I want you to write down one that might be hard for some of us, and that's family. So underneath friends, write down family. And I want you to think about how much hope is there right now for you. How much hope do you feel for your family? Scale of 1 10 being so much hope, 1 being like, man, this is tough, and I don't see it getting better. Go ahead and write that down. Be honest. All right, now we're going to look a little bigger. Right now, we're looking really big. This one will be a little lighter, maybe. But write down world, the world. So underneath family, right? The world. How much hope do you have? Do you feel that the world is good or getting better? We got so much room to grow and it's great. Or are you someone who's like, you know, this world is going down the tubes, right? Like I don't have much hope for our world. So scale 1 to 10, go ahead and write that down for the world. And then this last one, which might be really easy or really tough for some people, and it's this. I want you to write down under world, write down myself. Write down myself. And I want you to think about how much hope do you have for yourself? Some may be really excited for the future. You see yourself growing in many ways. You see your relationship with God growing, and you have a lot of hope for yourself, maybe a 6, 7, 8. Some of us are headed into winter and it's gloomy, it's dark, and we're not excited. We think of who we are and we're confused and we're like, I just don't see this getting better. And we're lower on hope. I want you to be honest with yourself and write down a number, 1 through 10. How much hope do you have for yourself? Well, guys, thank you for being honest. I want you to look over those numbers. We're going to spend a minute in prayer. We're going to bring these thoughts before God. And guys, my prayer for you is that where you are low on hope, where you put 8s, 9s, 10s, that you thank God for those moments. Be like, God, Lord, you are so good. Thank you for giving me the gift of friendship, giving me this family or whatever it may be. Praise God for that. And where you have lower numbers, just go to God and be like, God, this has been really tough. If you could, give me hope in these areas. Show me that it can get better. Make it better, Lord. So we're going to spend a moment in prayer and know that God can do things. As much as we wish we could do things, God is the one who can actually do things. So let's spend 1 minute in prayer. Let's be silent and pray through our list today. Let's do it.
Thank you.
Well, wonderful, guys. I pray that that was a good time for you. Again, spending time with God is number one. And if we're going to find any transformation in our own life or in our situations, it's going to be through the hand of God, because He's all powerful, of course. So I think that's a really special time. And my prayer for you is that you will find hope, and that these people sitting around the circle with you are people that can encourage you where you have lower hope, and people who can celebrate you where you have a high amount of hope. So that's transition straight into life update time. We're going to go around and do some life updates. Here's a quick life update from me.
What is up, everyone? It's time for the life update. As you can see, Zuko is very happily behind me. We are totally decorated for Christmas. Just no tree yet, unfortunately. But there's been a lot of cool things that have been going on. Some highs. It wasn't my birthday or Christmas, but Kelsey did this for me.
What?
Yeah, that's right. So right now, oh, here it is. We have a piano in the house, and I've been playing it a lot. It's great. Kelsey's amazing. So that was cool. We went to Ohio. Which was a really fun time. Got to see family. And got back. It's just been a good weekend. Ohio wasn't all perfect, though, because when we tried to drive back, this happened.
Well, guys, this is not fun. We're driving back from Ohio right now. Zuki's meowing. He's not happy, and the snow is pretty intense. I mean, this might be a low light of the week. This is kind of scary. Hopefully we get back. Please, Lord, get us back safely. Guys, the situation has deteriorated quickly. A 3-lane highway has turned into a 1-lane highway. And more lightning in the snowstorm. More thunder lightning, whatever that's called. So stay tuned.
But yes, we made it back safely, so that's good. That was a high. There were some lows for the week. One, Thea. Where are you, Thea? Kelsey's over here doing some reading. Thea got sick, which was not great. Also, we had some family sicknesses, some more family getting COVID, some extended family getting hit real hard with COVID, which was not good. And those were some pretty lower lows. And then God sightings. Guys, someone asked me, like, what is a God sighting? And that's a really good question. One thing for me that helps me see God sightings is going back through my habit journals and seeing what I was praying for. Things like strength for the day, things like the baby to be safe, things like an opportunity to love my enemies. What a weird prayer, but that's the prayer request you have when you start reading the Bible. And I think back, and God gave me opportunities, especially that one, love your enemies. I remember I had a really interesting conversation on two Sundays ago where a guy came attacking with his words, and I'm like, oh, here we go, an opportunity to love my enemies. And God gave me the strength to do so without getting too mad or hateful or anything like that. So that was really cool too. And of course the baby being safe and growing is a huge win in God's sighting. So I encourage you, if you don't know how to find God's sighting, see, are you praying? What are you praying for? And how is God showing up? How is God giving you peace in situations where you shouldn't have peace? How is God giving you joy in situations you shouldn't have joy? How is God encouraging you through friendships? Things like that. Awesome. So now it's your turn to do some life updates. Get to it.
Well, wonderful, guys. If you guys could hope the life updates were good. Guys, grab your scribe pads and grab your Bibles at this time, because we are going to be talking about the Word of God, and we're going to be talking about today's message. So, yeah, start getting your Bibles if you have them. Start getting them, and then get your scribe pads, get your pens and pencils out, because we're going to get ready to go. We are talking about hope today, and you can even put this at the very top. This is what I like to do at the top of your scribe pad. You could say December 1st. Is today December 1st? December 1st, Aaron, student night, and then this is going to be the topic today. It's this: where there is no hope, bring it. Where there is no hope, bring it. And that's going to be interesting. For those of you who have a Bible, open up to Jeremiah 33. Jeremiah 33 is kind of in the middle end of your Bible. If you notice, my Bible cover fell right off. So Jeremiah 33, this will give you a little bit better of a view. There we go. That far into your Bible. Jeremiah, one of the prophets. Jeremiah 33, and we're going to be reading from that soon. But guys, we are entering the Christmas season, and weirdly enough, when we get to the Christmas season, some weird words start popping up. Words that we've heard all the time, but every time we get to Christmas, it's like love, joy, peace, hope, Mary. I don't know. All these words, you just start seeing them on billboards. You start seeing them on walls. Literally, I'm looking at one that says Mary, one that says joy right there, because we just decorated, right? All these words start popping up, and you have to wonder, why are these words coming up now? Why aren't they just throughout the entire year? And today, I wanted to hone in on hope. Hone in on hope, because sometimes we hear the word hope and we're like, okay, how is hope any different from just wishing? Like, I wish I had a jet ski versus, man, I hope I get a jet ski. How are those any different? Is there a difference? If we hope in the Lord that God's going to do something, well, he's going to do something regardless of whether we hope in him, right? So why should we even need to hope? Is hoping just positive thinking? I'm thinking positive, so I hope things are going to get better. Is that all it is? Like, what is hope right now, and what does it look like to have hope? We just did an activity not too long ago where you guys wrote down how much hope you have in some certain areas. The thing is, sometimes it varies, right? But my hope for you is that you can start finding hope in Jesus, in God. Your hope is tied to God himself. Let's read from the Bible. We are going to look at Jeremiah 33, verses 14 through 16. It's going to be real quick. And be thinking about this. Jeremiah was a prophet, and this is when Israel, the nation of Israel, God's chosen people, remember, from Adam to all the way down to Noah to Abraham, Isaac, Jacob. They started Israel, the nation. Israel went to Egypt. They freed the slaves from Egypt, right? And they went into the promised land. All these things are happening. Israel, that nation which God promised, they have been exiled, and they've been experiencing very much nothing good. And they were promised by God. God promised them that there was going to be a Messiah, someone who would come and save them, someone who would restore this broken relationship between God and them, between humanity and them. So they were promised this Messiah, and this is what we're reading today. It says this, read with me, Jeremiah 33, 14 through 16. It says, "The days are coming, declares the Lord, when I will fulfill the good promise I made to the people of Israel and Judah. In those days and at that time, I will make a righteous branch sprout from David's line." It's kind of imagery. A righteous branch is kind of like an offspring. There's going to be a descendant from David. We all know King David. From King David's line. "He will do what is just and right in the land. In those days, Judah will be saved, and Jerusalem will live in safety. This is the name by which it will be called: the Lord, our righteous Savior." So way back in the beginning of the Bible, God promised Israel that he would make their nation great, that through Israel he would bless the entire world, and that through the line of Israel, through a descendant of David, he would come and bring restoration and healing, and someone was going to come and walk around the earth and heal and feed the poor and defend the oppressed, and someone was going to show us how to live and do it so perfectly that he would restore our relationship between God and humanity. What? That's so big. The thing is this, Israel is sitting in a really hard time. If you lived in these days, you would have put ones or twos or zeros for all of the questions we had asked. Friends, family, school, ones or zeros, because they were going through such a tough time. But God said, hey, I promise. I promise that you guys, your descendants, I will send someone to save and to seek and save the lost. I will send someone who is going to pave the way so that you can be with me, with God, for eternity. Whew, that's good news, man. That's good news. So Israel, when they heard this, there's hope. Man, I'm in a tough situation now, but I know that God is going to provide a Savior, spoiler alert, Jesus, who is going to show us how to live, and he's going to restore the relationship and make it possible for us to have a relationship with God. And then through us, he's going to make a world, Revelation, where there's no more crying or mourning or pain. Ooh, that gives me hope. I know that things can get better because I trust in the Lord, and the Lord tells us that things are gonna get better, that he will send someone to make things better, and that someone can live with us and work through us to bring about a beautiful kingdom where we feed the poor, where we defend the oppressed, where we find hope and joy in the Lord himself, and he's gonna send someone to make that way, and he sent Jesus. So, this is a big question. I want you to write this down. What is your hope in? What is your hope in? What is the thing that you go to when you think, wow, you know what could make this better? Sometimes on earth we think of material. You know what would make things better? If I got that sweet jet ski or that sweet video game that I really, that would make my life so much better. You know what would make my life so much better? Oh, I just hope that my friend realizes he or she was wrong and we become friends again. Oh, my life would be so much better. You know what would make life so much better? If my family stopped arguing, right? You know what would make life so much better is if my parent came back from moving away. You know what would make life so much better? ... That is where we find our hope sometimes. And my hope for you is this. That you don't find your hope in anything of this world, anything found in this world, but you find your hope in God himself. Because God himself is hope, and he gives hope. So if there's any situation, you could be in any situation, whatever it may be, and some of you are in some tough situations, but God can bring hope to that area of your life. All those ones and twos that you wrote down in your scribe pad, I pray that you would go to God with that, because he can. He has promised us so many things, and he makes good on his promises, and you need to find your hope in God. And when you do that, you start living with joy, with peace, with patience, with kindness, with goodness. All these words that we hear at Christmas, you will actually feel yourself, because the one who made all those good things will be living in you, and he is a good father who loves to give good things. So where there is hope, bring it. And this is the good thing. We've been talking about sharing our faith, right? And sometimes it's really scary to share our faith, but I bet you can think of one person. Right now, I want you to think of one person who is low on hope, who would have put ones and twos for a lot of those questions. Think of one person who's low on hope. Even write down their name. Go ahead and write down their name. And know that they can find abounding hope. They can find unending hope in Jesus. And so when we share our faith, we know that where there is not hope, we can bring it. Because we know the Lord, and the Lord can bring hope. So for those of you who have found hope in Christ, I encourage you and challenge you, whoever that person is, hey, would you want to come to our Christmas party? We have a great community. We're going to have a fun time. I encourage you to invite them to youth group on December 15th or to the Penfield Blast on December 11th. Guys, where there is not hope, bring it. Christ is our true source of hope. I'm going to hand it over to you, small group leaders, so you can do an activity today. All right, I'll see you next week. Merry Christmas.